Welcome back to Afternoon Express. Now, personal development coach Nogbonga Mbanga is passionate about helping women to harness their immense ability. And because of this, she has co-authored the book Meeting Your Power with DJ Zinhle, and is here today to help us understand the power of words and personal coaching. Welcome.
Thank you.
Lovely to have you with us. So your journey is very inspiring for me already because you had a couple of careers or you were meddling in different industries and you were doing well, mm-hmm. but then you arrived at this place of deciding that you wanted to empower young women to find their power, right? Mm-hmm. Which seems so vague and so vast and so big. Most of us are quick to want to cling to the things that are more defined, mm-hmm. where there's a title and these are the steps. Mm-hmm. So how did you overcome those kind of fears and those barriers to thinking like that?
I think the fact that my story of how I got here inspired me to continue. I think, you know, when you want to start your own business, you think about all these things being incorporated and you worry about all of these things. But I think when I look back at my whole life, I've always been in the personal development space, be it reading the book. I mean, how I got introduced was You Can Heal Your Life by Louise Hay.
I love that book. It changed my life.
Absolutely. That's where it all started. Yeah. I was still at Varsity, and that's how the journey started. And it kept evolving into being in a training space, developing people. So I think when I got to, I was working for one of the television broadcasting agencies, and I was in a two-day conference. And because you read books, you get to know what's going on and you become uncomfortable. They make you really uncomfortable. And I was looking at my life that I keep moving in organizations and I was realizing that I'm running away from myself. I was at this two-day conference. I didn't say anything. I decided at one point to ask a colleague to say something. So I made a note and said, this is what I think. Would you mind asking or do you mind sharing?
Yeah.
And the response was positive. And I gave her, I gave another person because I'm thinking maybe they like her. And then she asked the question and again, it was positive. And I realized I'm the one who's in the way. It's not the line manager, it's not the world, it's me.
Did you have a low self-esteem at that point?
Yep, a big one. A big one which started, I think, when I look back and I trace back where it started, it was because, you know, I felt that there was nothing right about my body. So I'd hit body image, serious body image.
So you were
issues.
Able to trace it down to just that bottom line to see this was the foundation of all. Because also when already you have that feeling like you're on your back foot, everything else just piggybacks onto that.
Absolutely.
Right?
Absolutely. You build the story and sometimes it's not even there. But one person says you have elephant legs. Another one says you've got a goat's chin. Another one says you are too tall. And suddenly you shrink. You don't see yourself.
Sure.
And that's for me how I've traced it back, that by the way, I'm not seeing myself. Therefore, how is my line manager and my team going to see me?
You.
Yeah.
What a beautiful story. So then how did you then start this journey? You decide, okay, you're going to empower many other women out there because obviously many women struggle with this. But it's interesting for me, you also speak about what role patriarchy plays in that journey and how it cages women from an early age.
So I started when I was in corporate, I've always been in the talent development space. Uh-huh. So developing people was my thing. And I was picking up as I would be talking about how do you want to be developed, that will send people on assertiveness course, but they're not assertive. What's going on? Hmm. So I got interested and I was studying. And at the time, coaching was still a new thing. So I was studying coaching with a behavioral coaching institute because for me, what was interesting was the behavior. Not that we've sent someone to a program, but what is the behavior that is stopping Nogbonga being her own best self? Mm. And that's how my journey started. I was reading books, I was putting information together to build this whole thing together. And I think what I was also seeing is that when you get to coach women, when you ask, you know, how did we get here? How did this story be what it is today?
Yeah.
You're successful and executive. Why is the story looking like this? And the story goes back to, you know, this is what was said to me by my brother, or this is what a friend of mine said about me. I mean, I had one who said, you know, because I had a moment where my armpits was smelling, and I decided, you know what, I'm going to be successful to prove them wrong.
Wow.
But the painful thing is a story that you stay with yourself, that every time you try and rise, you then think, maybe they'll find out. that I'm a fraud, or maybe they'll find out that something is not right about me because I think that I'm not enough. So it's the things that you hear from outside. If you think about it, it's the stories that come from outside and you make them our own without challenging them. And so what I do with my clients, one of the things that I simply ask, how do you know, where are the facts? Where are the facts that says you've got elephant legs?
Or where's the truth that you hold this up to the mirror, you mirror this lie, and what is the truth? Yes. How do you find the truth for yourself?
Yeah.
And how do you coach your clients to find the truth?
It's the questions. There's a lot of questions. Questions are so powerful
because they're
hard, but they make you to be curious. They make you to be curious. I had this client, it's a male client, who was saying, I'm stuck. This is someone successful in a corporate space, multinet. And he said to me, you know, when I asked you why you're stuck, and he said, I don't know. I said, but you do know. Because for me, is that wisdom lies within you. So when I continue to challenging him about, you know, is there something that you've put together? And he said, actually, I do have something. And he read this whole powerful idea that he has about his future, about his vision to the world and what he can bring. And he's done lots of work behind the scenes. So I asked him, so what's the issue? Because when you speak about it, you can see the power. It's there. Your eyes are shining. And he said to me, I'm afraid of what I have to become. I'm afraid, how is the world going to receive me, respond to what I'm putting together? Rejection is tough.
It sounds so simple, but it can be such a big obstacle in a person's mind, especially when you don't have another perspective speaking into that, right? So that's the voice you've become.
Yeah, yeah. And the voice from the outside that says, I'm not enough. Yeah. Let me do more because it's done so much, but because it's afraid the world might not respond very well. Wow. Rejection is
it can be very deep-seated.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
How have young women responded to the book?
Positively. I hear some of the feedback will say, it's a go-to book for me if I'm feeling down, or it's a go-to book when I want to understand a topic around managing fear. I mean, one of the powerful moments we had with Zinhle, we're doing book signing in Pretoria.
Yeah.
And so we would interact as we're signing. So who are you? What are you doing? And this woman started crying. And he said, I was afraid. You have no idea. I can't get out of this room. One other lady said, I'd already given up. But for some reason, I took this book and I read it. And I've only read 2 chapters. But I've decided to continue with my own story.
That's absolutely beautiful. Thank you so much for sharing your time and for sharing your wisdom with the world in this book.
Yeah. Thank you. Yeah. Thank you.
So remember to enter our amazing competition and stand a chance of getting your signed copy of Meeting Your Power by Nokubonga Mbanga. To stand a chance of winning, SMS the keywords win plus your name and city to 33650. SMSs are at 1 rand 50 each. No free SMSs apply. T's and C's are found on afternoonexpress.co.za. Enter the competition, because if you don't, I'll enter the competition and I'll win the book.